you do not sing, but that you would hum instead when we're doing a song. If you don't know what humming is when you put your lips lightly together and then you use your singing voice behind that. So you just heard me hum hot cross buns. I know it's not the same as singing, but you'll get to listen to Mr. Weed or to me sing, and you can hum along if you're in the building. We may forget to say to hum, so if we say please sing along, but you're in the building, we're trying to hopefully remind you to hum instead. If you're at home, we hope you'll use your singing voice. Now, if you go home and you really love a song that we did in school and you didn't get to sing it and you had to hum, I hope you'll go back and sing that song once you get home. I'm sorry that we can't use our singing voices in school right now. It makes me so sad, but I know that you'll sing whenever you get the opportunity, and I do look forward to the day that we get to sing together again. But again, if you're in the building, you're humming, and if you're at home, you may sing. Thank you.
All right, boys, we're going to stand up. We're going to stretch the sides. Here we go. Stretch. And another way. And up. Roll your shoulders backwards. And forwards. And head to first side. Head second side. And normal. Breathe in. Remember that our hands come apart. That means that we're going to inhale. We're taking air in. And then as we come back together, we are exhaling and hissing like a snake. So, don't let that top hand move. Let's see if we can do it. Ready and breathe. Let it out. And breathe in. Now, and one final time. And let's warm up our voice a little smooth, following our roller coaster here. Fingers up. Woo! Oh, very nice. All right, let's see. How about a different one? What if it looked like this? Oh, I don't know if we can do that one or not. Let's see. Fingers up. Oh, very good job.
Please be my echo as we practice singing some solfege patterns on the staff. Before we start, notice that I'm putting a letter beneath the first note. That letter is the solfege syllable we'll be starting on. So do is the first space every time. We skip up over that next line to the next note on the next space. That would be mi, that's right. And then we skip to the next space, which is so. So will you please be my echo? Do mi, so mi. So, mi, so, so. So, mi, so. Mi, so, mi.
Do, do, mi, do. Do, mi, do, mi. Mi, do, mi, so. So, so, mi, do.
Nice job. This time, you're going to try to sing the patterns before I sing them for you. If you need more time than I have allowed, you can always push pause, see if you can figure out the pattern, and then I'll sing it for you so you can check yourself. Good luck. I know you can do it.
Ready, sing.
You sang
do mi so mi.
You're correct.
Ready, try, so. Good if you sang so mi so so.
You're correct. You sang
so mi mi so.
You got it right.
Ready, sing.
If you sang
mi mi so mi,
that was it. If you sang
mi so mi so,
you were right.
Ready, sing.
If you sang
so so mi mi,
that was correct.
1, 2, ready, sing.
If you sang
do, do, mi, do,
you are correct.
1, 2, ready, sing.
If you sang
so, la, so, mi,
you've got it.
1, 2, ready, sing.
If you sang
do, mi, do, mi,
you got it right.
Ready, sing.
If you sang
mi, do, mi, so,
you are correct.
1, 2, ready, go.
If you sang
so, so, mi, do,
you got it right.
1, 2, ready, go.
If you sang
so, la, so, mi,
you are correct. Great job. Wonderful work practicing singing the notes on the staff.
Verse 2. So, it sounds very much the same. It just has a few different words. Went down to the old mill stream to fetch a pail of water. Put one arm around my
want you to figure out where he's going.
Went down to the old mill stream to fetch a pail of water. Put one arm around my wife, the other around my daughter.
If you said that he went down to the old mill stream, you are absolutely correct. He did go down to the old mill stream. Now, what did he go down to the old mill stream for? Let's figure that out.
Went down to the old mill stream to fetch a pail of water. Put one arm around my wife, the other around my daughter.
If you said that he went down to get a pail of water, to fetch a pail of water, you are correct. Let's see. Then he says that he put his arm around someone. Who was the first person he put his arm around?
Went down to the old mill stream to fetch a pail of water. Put one arm around my wife, the other around my daughter.
If you said his wife, you are correct. All right, and then who was the second person he put his arm around? Let's figure that out.
Went down to the old mill stream to fetch a pail of water. Put one arm around my wife, the other around my daughter.
Who did he put his arm around the second time? If you said that he put his arm around his daughter the second time, you are correct. Great job. All right, so let's go all the way through verse 2, and then we'll try and put the two verses together. Here we go.
Ready and go. Went down to the old mill stream to fetch a pail of water. Put one arm around my wife, the other around my daughter.
All right. If you think you got that, let's put it with verse 1. Here we go.
Ready and go. Great big house in New Orleans, 40 stories high. Every room that I've been in, filled with pumpkin pie. Went down to the old mill stream to fetch a pail of water. Put one arm around my wife, the other around my daughter.
All right, practice that. Pause it. Practice those two verses. And then when you're ready, let's add the third verse. Now that you've come back and are ready for verse 3, let's learn it really quick. It goes,
fare thee well, my darling girl. Fare thee well, my daughter. Fare thee well, my darling girl, with the golden slippers on her.
I'm looking for which two phrases were the same. Let's do the phrases on that. Listen to see if it's 1 and 2, 1 and 3, 1 and 4, 2 and 3, 2 and 1, whatever the combination is. Let's see what you think.
Ready and go. Fare thee well, my darling girl. Fare thee well, my daughter. Fare thee well, my darling girl, with the golden slippers on her.
Which two were the same? Let's check our answer if we think we know.
Ready and go. Fare thee well, my darling girl. Fare thee well, my daughter. Fare thee well, my darling girl, with the golden slippers on her.
If you said 1 and 3, you are correct. All right, so what was different about number 2? Figure that out this time.
Fare thee well, my darling girl. Fare thee well, my daughter. Fare thee well, my darling girl, with the golden slippers on her.
What was different about the second one and the first and third one? Oh, the second one said daughter at the end. You're right. So, can you sing 1 and 3? And I will do 1 and 3. I'll do number 2. Here we go.
Ready and
does she have on her? See if you can figure out that outfit. I'll sing everything. Fare thee well, my darling girl. Fare thee well, my daughter. Fare thee well, my darling girl, with the golden slippers on. Oh, she did have golden slippers. Good job. You're going to sing number phrases 1 and 3 for me, and I'll sing 2 and 4. Here we go. Ready and go. Fare thee well, my daughter, with the golden slippers on her. Can you add in the second phrase, the daughter one? Let's see. Ready and go. You think you can do all 4 of those phrases? Let's see. Ready and go. Fare thee. Let's sing it one last time together, and then you can go and practice that. Here we go. Ready and go. Fare thee well, my darling girl. Fare thee well, my daughter. Fare thee well, my darling girl, with the golden slippers on her. All right, so pause if you need to work on verse 3. If not, let's see if we can do all 3 phrases, all 3 verses together. Here we go.
Ready and go. Great big house in New Orleans, 40 stories high. Every room that I've been in, filled with pumpkin pie.
Sometimes it could be the same rhythm pattern repeated. Sometimes it could be a whole line is repeated later in the song. Sometimes a big section gets repeated again at the end. Like in I Love the Mountains. We hear the boom diad, a chorus part, in between every verse. So our form would be A, B, A, B. Because we have that same part coming back. And the verses are the same melody, it's just different words. So we're going to use some rhythm patterns to practice arranging some music, however we want. I have some examples for you, and then you can do it on your own and create however you would like to create the form and the pattern of the music to be. So every time we see a circle, we're going to say this and clap this rhythm. Will you say and clap with me? 1, 2, ready, go. Toddy, toddy, ta, ta. Great, let's do that one more time. Ready, go. Toddy, toddy, ta, ta. Beautiful. When we see a square, we'll be clapping and saying this rhythm. Ready, go. Ta, toddy, ta. Good. You remember, ta shows 2 beats. So we start here on beat 1 and then go to our elbow for the second beat. Let's clap that square again. Ready, go. Ta, toddy, ta. Very good. And then when we see a star, we're going to say, ready, go, ta, rest, ta-di, ta. Good. Let's do that again. Ready, go, ta, rest, ta-di, ta. Great. And now in a piece of music, we don't actually say rest, right? We would be quiet. So let's try it once with just silence on that beat. Ready, go, ta, ta-di, ta. Beautiful job. Now we're going to be arranging these shapes into different patterns so that we can try to create a longer piece of rhythmic music out of those building blocks. Let's practice clapping our form based on shape. So instead of using letters like A, B, and C, we'll be using our shapes today to create our form. Our first one says circle, square, circle, square. So let's try that. Ready, go. Toddy, toddy, ta, ta. Ta, toddy, ta. Toddy, toddy, ta, ta. Ta, toddy, ta. Very good. And if you need to go back and try rhythm again, you can always rewind and try it again on your own. The next rhythm pattern is star, square, circle, circle. Let's give that one a try. Ready, go. Ta, toddy, ta. Ta, toddy, ta. Toddy, toddy, ta. Ta, toddy, toddy, ta, ta. Very nice. Our next pattern says circle, star, square, circle. Let's give it a try. One, two, ready, go. Toddy, toddy, ta, 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 toddy, ta, ta, toddy, ta, toddy, toddy, ta, ta. Very good. Our last pattern says square, star, square, square. Let's give that one a try. One, two, ready, go. Ta, toddy, ta, ta, toddy, ta. Ta, toddy, ta, ta, toddy, ta. Very, very nice. Now, we use shapes today, but often we use letters to explain, right? So if we go back and we look at that last example where we had a square, star, square, square, we would call that normally A, B, A, because A is our square, B is our star, and we went back and we repeated the square again, so that would say A, A. Right? So if we give each shape a letter name, then we can also understand different forms in music so that we can see what those patterns are. We'll be practicing more with form later on, but now you kind of understand that form in music, it's based on the patterns. For I Love the Mountains, we're going to be adding some body percussion. Only on the boom diatas though, okay? It's gonna start with pats on our right leg. So you're going to go three just like that on boom diada. So three pats on your right leg, and then you'll do three exactly the same way on your left. So you'll go boom diada, boom diada, boom diada, boom diada. Back. Okay, so that's our pattern. Right leg, left leg, snap, snap, pat, clap, and you start again. Let's try just on the boom diada section. One, two, here we go. Very good. Every time we get to the boom diadas, you are going to do that body percussion along while you sing. Try to do both things at the same time. You'll see me on one screen doing body percussion. You'll see me on the other screen singing along. Okay, here we go with our singing and our body percussion.
Boom diada, boom diada, boom diada. Good.
getting that in there. We're almost ready to turn the whole thing into a giant round so you can try it in different parts. This is a great time for you to go and choose an instrument so you can play along to the beat with me. Got your scraper, shaker, or drum? Awesome. So you're just going to play a nice steady beat as we do our song. I'm going to show you first the chorus part that we'll be singing all together. Now, what I teach you is just the first part. We add on every single time, but the melody stays the same. So you'll understand how that works here in just a minute. The first time through, it goes like this. The tree was in the hole, and the hole was in the ground, and the green grass grew all around and around, and the green grass grew all around. Could you try that with me? Ready? Here we go. Ready, sing. The tree was in the hole, and the hole was in the ground, and the green grass grew all around and around, and the green grass grew all around. Okay, now, every verse you're going to be my echo, and in the verse I'm going to tell you something else to add on to the story of what's happening in the song. You have to remember it with me, and we're going to add it on to that chorus part. You'll see what I mean as we go. All right, be my echo, please. Oh, in the woods, there was a tree, the prettiest little tree that you ever did see. And the tree was in the hole, and the hole was in the ground, and the green grass grew all around and around, and the green grass grew all around. Now on that tree, there was a branch, the prettiest little branch that you ever did see. And the branch was on the tree, and the tree was in the hole, and the hole was in the ground, and the green grass grew all around and around, and the green grass grew all around. Good. Do you see how to add it on? Here's the next verse. Now on that branch, there was a twig, the prettiest little twig that you ever did see.
And the green grass grew all around.
Now on the
ground, and the green grass grew all around. Now on that feather, there was a bug, the prettiest little bug that you ever did see. And the bug was on the feather, and the feather was on the wing, and the wing was on the bird, and the bird was on the egg, and the egg was in the nest. Twig, and the twig was on the branch, and the branch was on the tree, and the tree was in the hole, and the hole was in the ground, and the green grass grew all around and around, and the green grass grew all around. Now on that bug, there was a germ, the prettiest little germ that you ever did see. And the feather was on the wing, and the wing was on the bird, and the bird was on the egg, and the egg was in the nest, and the nest was on the twig, and the twig was on the branch, and the branch was on the tree, and the tree was in the hole, and the hole was in the ground, and the green grass grew all around and around, and the green grass grew all around. One more. Now on that germ, there was a smile. The prettiest little smile that you ever did see. And the smile was on the germ, and the germ was on the bug, and the bug was on the feather, and the feather was on the wing, and the wing was on the bird, and the bird was on the egg, and the egg was in the nest, and the nest was on the twig, and the twig was on the branch, and the branch was on the tree, and the tree was in the hole, and the hole was in the ground, and the green grass grew all around and around, and the green grass grew all around.
Woo-wee! Did you make it through that? That's a crazy song, but it's super fun to see if I can remember it all, and if you can remember it all too. Hope you had fun. We got to learn a little bit about George Frederick Handel in the last lessons, so let's review a little bit about him. Do you remember what country Handel was from? It begins with a G or a J sound. Do you remember what it was? If you said Germany, you were correct. He was from Germany, which is in Europe. There you can see the arrow pointing to that green country. Do you remember what musical time period he composed during? This one begins with a B. Yes, the Baroque era. Baroque. It sounds like broke. The big joke is always, if it ain't Baroque, don't fix it, right? Broke. Baroque. Sounds really similar. Do you remember what Baroque means? It means ornamented, embellished, or complex sounding, right? So all of his music was more complex or ornamented or embellished than the music that came before him in the Renaissance era. So Handel's dad wasn't musical, and he wanted Handel to study law and become a lawyer. But Handel really loved music. He was given a clavichord when he was 7. A clavichord is pictured here right beside us. See how it has kind of like a piano keyboard, but it wasn't played the same way as the piano. It kind of had these little metal pieces that would tap on the strings when you pushed down the key. So the piano hadn't even been invented yet, and this was the instrument that existed first. Well, Handel received a clavichord like this, and with his mom's help, he would practice in the attic where his father couldn't hear him, and that was when he was 7. Handel began composing music when he was about 9 years old. Some of you guys are 9 years old, or even older. Can you imagine that he was writing complex and really impressive music starting around the age of 9? Well, his father eventually gave in and allowed Handel to learn several other instruments. They're all pictured here. The first one that looks like a big piano, that's called a harpsichord. Again, the piano still hadn't been invented, and so the harpsichord was the instrument they were using. The harpsichord's different than the piano because instead of the strings being hit by hammers like a piano, The strings were plucked by little quills or the ends of pointy feathers they would use to pluck the string. So it has kind of a little tingy sound when you play it. And it has two keyboards. I've never seen a piano with two keyboards. In the middle is a pipe organ. Look at how huge it is. Guess what? That's not even the whole thing. We can't see the keyboard part. There's at least 2 to 3 keyboards for your hands and a keyboard for your feet to play. And the sound comes out of those big pipes. Isn't that amazing? And look how ornamented and embellished the architecture around the pipes is. It looks super fancy. You know why? Because it's Baroque. That's right. He also learned to play the violin. So some of you all know how to play keyboard instruments like the piano, and you know how to play the violin. So you are learning some instruments just like Handel did. We're going to listen to a harpsichord suite in D minor. Now, I wasn't able to find the harpsichord suite in D minor played on the harpsichord. I could only find it played on the piano because harpsichords are kind of hard to come by these days. We're going to listen to it played on the piano. But then I want you to keep listening because I found a really cool version of the same song, and it starts off real similarly, but then somebody has taken some modern music ideas and made it sound really cool. So I want you to compare the two. We're going to listen to the first piece that's just the piano, and then the second piece with the new modern ideas, and you tell me and compare those two pieces. I would love to hear from you and hear which was your favorite and what you thought was interesting about the two different pieces. I hope you enjoy listening. Here's the different one.
Thank you.
were those pieces the same or different? I hope you enjoyed listening to both versions and you have a great week.